Welcome to Weekly Tech Tip number 16. Today I want to show you how you can output the machining time per operation or the toolpath cutting time within a list. So use case behind, it's let me post-process this operation here or the program group. Background is following from out of the box of Post Configurator. We outputted a list in the top here, a tool list with the processing times or the cutting times. And the problem, or not problem, issue here is this is currently only output in the listing window. And I want to output this, for example, in the header of a program, in the end of program. I want to output this per operation, or maybe in an external file. So to do that, we cannot reuse this list here directly, so we have to create our own list. To do that, in preparation of that, I create three properties here. You can see the last weekly tech tip how to create those properties. Finally, we have output machining time per operation. Set it off or on. Where it should be located at the start of program, end of program, per operation, external file, and what should be the extension if we use external file. So, as already, I will use the community layer for that. As I said, I prepared those properties here, so there's a section for the properties, and now we have to link it to TCL and implement our code. To do that, I have create here a new block, machine cutting time. And what I want to reuse, because I don't want to write all the TCL stuff now, I want to re reuse a command from a workshop for Post Configurator, which was created by the participants. And we are happy to share this. So finally, it's calculating the machine time here. And divide it into hours, minutes, and a second, and output it. So I will reuse this code for my procedure. So that means first we need a new procedure here, and let's name this cutting time per operation. And as I said, let's reuse the code. So first the calculation here. Okay, so as the last time, we need to cycle through the pretreatment to get this information. And for sure, the MOM machine time is the complete time. In the NX help, you have some documentation about the variables, the machine time related variables. And you see you have multiple things here, and we want to concentrate today on the MOM toolpath time for each operation. Okay, so that means first we have to collect this information, because it doesn't matter if we want to output this at the start of program, end of program, or external file. We have to collect this information, and that means we have to add it to the pretreatment. So let's do that. Copy the existing one here for the MOM tool diameter. Paste it, and it's let's copy it. Much better approach. Toolpath time. We want to collect the MOM toolpath time. So now, similar to the tool list, we have to cycle through the operations. So let's also steal this code here and say, let's say, okay, for each element, we want to cycle and doing something in the operation list. So now, important here, we don't want to take care of the machine time. We want for each element to get the pretreatment time. Again, let's steal us some code. We can use this one here. So get a value from the pretreatment from current operation and the actual value. And instead of the MOM machine time here, we're not using for sure the tool name, we're using the toolpath time, and bring this in our calculation. other variables here are related to this one. So that means this will finally give out back the hours, minutes and seconds. So next step, let's have a simple step here first. Just let us doing a mom output text and output the information. In this case, it's toolpath operation time. And then we want to get, oh wait, toolpath operation, let's say here, dollar E. And the time is now the dollar hours. Escape, double point, dollar minutes, escape, double point, and dollar the seconds. So that means now for each element we cycle through the list, and for each operation it will output those things. So now we have to call it. First, let's do it without any dependencies to the properties. First, let's check that this is working. So let's call this in the start of program. We already did in the for the tool list here. So let's call it here, cutting time per operation, and let's test our code if it's now working. So post process. Okay, and let's go to the top here. And now we have our times. So adaptive milling, it's 32 minutes and 26 seconds. So let's double check here. We can see it here, 32 minutes and 26 seconds. Okay, so that now works great. We get our times. For sure, we can do some additional formatting here. Let's also do that. That it looks much better from the representation. For that, for sure, there are multiple ways to formatting those kind of strings. I will use just the expression here and the ticket command for round, that we not have floating points inside of it. As I said, there are multiple ways to format the strings with a format command. And so that's this one. Now let's copy this, place it here. We need this one and this one. And again, this one and this one. Just a short test that my everything is still working, that I don't get any TCL errors. So, and now it looks like 0033 seconds. For sure, you can now, yeah, let's also do that to make it much clearer what is. Let's say here that is hours, that is minute, and this is seconds. So again, just to verify everything is working. It's working. I have now 0 hours, 0 minutes, 33 seconds. Okay, so now we have to connect it to our properties here. To do that, finally, currently we call it just in the start of program here. As the last time, we can modify the buffers when it should be outputted as needed here. So means first we need if condition here to ask if our property is switched on. To do that, let's ask the object. So we have this general options object. Go back to here. We want to ask if the property is set to on. The machining list output here. Okay, so and is this is equal to 1, then we want to execute some action. So and now we have a sub-dependency. That means want to have it at the start of program, end of program, per operation, or as an external file. In this case, I would say let's use a switch command here. And again, we ask the property value. So let's copy first this one. That was one too much. And now we ask the machining time output location property. One thing here, I just see it now. The ID, this value here, should be set to one of the default options. So let's say it's the start of program is a default option. And now copy it again to here. And now we have the options. 0, we want to execute something. 0 means in the start of program, so directly we can call this procedure. 1 means we want to output at the end of program. 2 means per operation, and 3 means as an external file. So let's start with format it a little bit to keep the overview. So first, I think this is clear. It's start of program. We directly call it, and it's outputting something. So option 1, we want to have it at the end of program. To do that, we need to modify the buffer dynamically for the end of program, and that we then call this cutting time per operation. To do that, let's use the inspect tool to identify the buffer. So show inspect tool on post process, get our information here, and let's see the end of program buffer. End of program, and directly let's use, for example, this one. So this now depends if you want to have it before the M2 or after the M2. Let's say we want to append it after the M2, means append, copy to clipboard, close it, go back to our community layer, and now we're calling here our cutting time per operation. End of program cutting times. So at this point, let's validate general options. So start of program, let's check end of program, save. And if I now post process, I would expect it is not working. So question is why? See the end of program buffer. So it not depends my tech. That means maybe it's not running into the switch condition here. So let's double check what is the value we get back here from the property. To do that, let's doing a mom output listing device, and just let's call the value and see what is the value. So this is a typical way how to do debug the property. Okay, and again, let's post process. Don't get any output. Now let's check. Okay, so makes sense. I don't switched on the machining time per operation. So let's switch on this. Again, post process. Now the output is working. That's great. And option is 1. So everything was fine. I just missed to set up my property correctly. Can happen. Okay, so let's remove this from output to listing device here. So that means case one is working, start of program, end of program. Case two is per operation. It's similar thing we can do like we did for the end of program using the inspect tool and post-process the operation. Search for the buffer we need. In this case, we want to output in the operation in the start of pass. So let's use the start of pass and we have the operation header command already here. And let's say, okay, we want to use that and append or prepend. Or we directly want it behind this message line. So to identify, you see it's this add info line. That means let's insert this is the info line and we want to insert something after the info line. So copy to clipboard, back to our layer, paste it here, and now we just can steal us this one here. Again, and let's copy the tag here also. And this is our start of pass cutting times. Okay, then let's switch the property per operation, save the modification. Now we have to post-process a little bit more. And we should now get for each operation the cutting time. So now for sure we have one problem here. It is calling all the operations every time. That means we need some modifications in our procedure to just output only the current operation. So let's also do that. Means again, we can ask this property here of the machining time. And now we have to implement this one in our cutting time per operation, because only in the case of when we want to output all the stuff, we need it there. So if this is set to 2, or is it unequal to 2, that is correct. Only then we want to execute the complete procedure here. So that means only in the case of in operation, we not really need the pretreatment because all the variables are directly available. Nevertheless, we can use the same procedure here and let's do the else condition. And let's copy the same code from here. But now the difference, as I mentioned, we don't need the pretreatment because the mom tool pass time is directly available in this context. So let's just get the value of the mom tool pass time. For sure, we have to remove the things from pretreatment here. And want to output calculating the time. And instead of this $E, we directly can use the mom operation name and outputting the time in the same context. So let's test this one. Post-process again all the programs and we will hopefully see in a second. Now you see we have the tapping operation just outputting the tapping time. We have chamfering, modulate and outputting the times. So this also now is working. That means finally we have still open the external file. And to do that, let's also extend the switch condition with the last missing one. And in this context, as we already did in the toolpath list, we can reuse the code here we already have implemented. And so let's deal again from the tool path, or not sorry, from the tool list. That means we have to ask the property and then calling our procedure, open a new output file, and all the stuff. So let's copy this block here and paste it here. So this if condition we don't need. So means also the bracket should be there. And now let's say it's not a tool list, it's machining time list output name. I mean, this also can be controlled by everyone. As fixed names, whatever you want. Create a property, depend on the part file, whatever. The extension here we should get from our property we created. This extension here, copy it and paste it here. So this is our file name. Then we close the current output file. We open a new output file. In this case, for sure, this one. Now we're calling our procedure to just print the output into this file, cutting time per operation. And again, we have to close the machining list output file name now. And we have to open again our MOM output file with the origin and C code. So that should also now work. Let's test it. And to do that, let's post-process. Let's use TXT2 extension. Save. Post-process. First, we have to validate that our post-processors run. That looks good. We should not now have any information in our listing window here about the tools. So there is nothing inside. So let's go to the temp directory. And we see our machining time here. TXT file. Let's check this file. And we have now all the information inside of it. Okay, so that's it about how to create file with machining times per operation or the cutting time. You can reuse this code as every time I will upload this layer to the manufacturing forum. And hope you enjoy it. Thank you. Bye bye.